What's going on, my pretty pandas? It's your huggable hipster here, and welcome back to another Psychologically Gaming, where we are going to be discussing Leon S. Kennedy. He is my bias in the Resident Evil universe. I do have to say this right now. Oh, you guys like my cup, by the way? It says good morning, even though it's not morning, but you know, it's good morning. I think Leon Kennedy is best known for his performance in Resident Evil 4. Performance. Look at me saying like he's like an actor or something. Now, Leon first appears in Resident Evil 2, and then later on in Resident Evil 4. His story, I think, is one of the most interesting in the Resident Evil universe, given the fact that Leon Kennedy is one of the people who seems the most normal, and he kind of seems to me the most human. He seems the most human, he seems the most normal, he seems the most like he wants a cure for this disease. Now, the only one who comes close to that kind of ideology and way of thinking, I think, is Chris Redfield, but we'll discuss him in another Psychologically Gaming. Now, you're going to be surprised with me on this. This is more going to be a personality analysis of Leon Kennedy. It's not going to be a full-out psychoanalysis because the two things are very distinct, but very different. I feel like Leon Kennedy, he doesn't have anything that really jumps out to me, like a slight obsessive-compulsive disorder and a little bit of anxiety. Obviously, I mean, you know, look at the world he's in. But with his personality, I really want to tackle that because he is a very interesting and very unique personality in the game. Rose, it's not something that just becomes completely different in another game. Like, you see his personality grow from one game and mature to the next. In Resident Evil 2, he was this young rookie cop on the first day of his job trying to figure out what the hell is going on. In Resident Evil 4, you see him as a mature agent who has to save and protect the president's daughter. So he goes from one point in his life being a rookie cop to this point where he's basically an undercover cop, which kudos. I mean, you know, if you want me to buy you a drink, honey, I will. I gotta stop being so thirsty. Oh my god. Now, Leon does appear in several animations of Resident Evil that are short films, and those are really enjoyable. I do have to say, I'm not just being biased, but you know, I am being biased in a way, but they are very, very good. And you even see his character grow there. He's a mature man by that point. He's not just a rookie cop anymore. With his personality, I feel like it's so distinct and separate from the entire Resident Evil universe. It's very unique. And whenever I say that it's separate, I mean that whenever I was playing as Jill or I was playing as Chris in the Resident Evil universe, I felt like their personalities and their characteristics were very similar. Just one was a male and one was a female, and I always shipped them both. But when it came to Leon Kennedy's personality, it was very diverse. It was integrated with all these different facets of emotion that I really liked. Not to be confused with everything that a character has whenever you're building a video game, that's entirely different, but whenever you have certain characters that you're passionate about more so than the other, I feel like it stands out. And when Resident Evil 4 came out, it was this big thing, like, oh my god, it's the fourth game, can it even measure up to everything else? And nobody expected that it would be one of the best Resident Evil games ever. We all know and love Ashley, don't we? There's always been a positive reception when it came to Leon Kennedy, and actually he was named Nintendo Power's Most Liked Hero. Like one of the articles that I read previous in preparation for today's video, he was named in 2010 as Nintendo's favorite hero, 14th favorite hero. And that's major. That's really cool. And it states in the article that it went from a glorified meter maid with a bad haircut to a tough guy. Now, there are several games that Leon Kennedy has appeared in besides Resident Evil 2 and Resident Evil 4. Appeared in Resident Evil Degeneration, Resident Evil Damnation, Resident Evil Vendetta, and live-action CG films. Resident Evil Retribution. He also has a love interest, I believe a love interest, with Ada Wong in the series, considering the fact that they always fought side by side since the second game in 98. But the one thing that really caught my attention with Leon Kennedy, and it's not something that I think really a lot of people would consider to be portrayed within his character, but he has an overarching empathy and simpatico with the undead. Looking at it from this standpoint of where he not only wants to find a cure, he wants to find something, well, Chris Redfield wants to find a cure too, but I feel like Chris Redfield is like the rough and tough guy. Leon Kennedy is more of like the good cop who wants to figure everything out. Kind of carried that empathetic nature, that good-willed Samaritan vibe throughout his career, and I feel like it really made his character one of the strongest ones. He's one of the most diverse characters in the game, hands down. I mean, he goes from rookie cop to Secret Service agents trying to find the president's daughter. It's a hefty thing to go through his entire career and still keep a level of empathy, still keep a level of kindness to a certain extent. Now, in completion with Resident Evil 3 Nemesis, if you complete there the game, there is like kind of an epilogue that tells you the story of Leon Kennedy, that he joined the federal government. In a short part in Resident Evil Code Veronica that came out in the year 2000, by the way, there is a snippet of where Claire contacts Leon to relay information. So there is his character that is constantly throughout the Resident Evil series. It may not have been in the first game, but he has been a constant and consistent character throughout the series since number 2. So have Jill and Chris, but the thing is that with the other characters, you don't see the variance in emotion and the variance in what they do for a living, you know? Like, you see all these different things that, you know, Chris has done, that Jill has done, but in accordance to how they behave with what they currently do as a job, they're still the same emotionally and everything like that, if that makes sense. I don't know. I think this is more coming from like someone who's worked in a gaming company, because you see the characters differently. You see everything differently after you've been in that kind of environment to an extent. So for me, something that I consider completely different, someone might say, oh, you're completely wrong. What are you even talking about? And then he comes back in Resident Evil 6. Resident Evil 7, he did not make an appearance. Chris actually made the appearance, and it's like, my man Chris coming back to save the day. So who knows, maybe in the 8th game he will make a guest appearance, he will have something to do with that game, which actually I'm gonna make a prediction right now. Leon Kennedy will make an appearance in Resident Evil 8, mark my words. Resident Evil 7 was just leading to something possibly bigger, where you're going to have all the characters come back, mark my words. Jill Valentine, Rebecca Chambers, Billy, oh my god, I want the character Billy to come back so badly. And there wasn't really much to Leon Kennedy that I found besides that. I feel like he's very empathetic towards zombies, towards the undead, towards the entire thing that's going on with people who are fighting against the Umbrella Corporation and with the Umbrella Corporation. It would make a very good double spy. But yeah, if you guys like my face and want to do, please be sure to subscribe and hit the bell down below, because I make videos every weekday and a podcast every Saturday. Stay casually nerdy, you guys, and I will talk to you all in tomorrow's video, where we will be trying to get over it. Peace.